Te doy gracias en esta hora, Señor, y te pido por nuestra isla y las vírgenes, Santa Cruz, San Tomás y Sañón, que tú bendigas nuestras islas y que bendigas nuestra nación. En el nombre de Jesús oramos. Amén y amén.
Let us pray. God Almighty, we humble ourselves in your presence even now. We acknowledge, God, that you are the great I am. We acknowledge that you are sovereign of this universe. We acknowledge that you are omnipotent, omnipresent, and omniscient. We acknowledge that, God, you are God all by yourself, and hallelujah, there is absolutely none like you. You are the Lord and Master of all that you survey. You are Jehovah Jireh, Jehovah Nissi, Jehovah Sitkenu, Jehovah Shammah, Jehovah Shalom. Light of the world, you step down into our darkness. God, open our eyes that we may see you clearly. Open our ears that we may hear and obey. God, in spite of ourselves, you love us with an everlasting love. And you have called us to love each other as you have loved us. Oh, how we have failed you, God. We have dishonored you in our thoughts and our words and our deeds. In this Lenten season, you are calling us to repentance. We recognize that your wrath has been kindled against us, and you have called your entire universe to attention. You have turned this world upside down, yet we are defiant. Father, forgive us. We acknowledge that you have the whole world in your hands and that you've been speaking to us long before COVID-19, 9/11, wars and rumors of wars, mudslides and earthquakes in diverse places, destructive fires, devastating hurricanes. Yet our ears are filled with wax so we cannot hear. Father, forgive us. You have called us to a global quarantine, giving us time to acknowledge the folly of our ways and to recognize that, oh God, you are still on the throne, yet we defy the order to exercise social distancing and refuse to stay at home for our own safety and for the safety of those you have called us to love. You have given us guidelines through the governor, CDC, and our health authorities, and some are not taking these seriously. God, forgive us. We thank you for the leadership of Governor Bryan and his cabinet, members of the legislature, and those on the front lines. God, bless them and strengthen them for the days ahead. Help us to recognize your voice, Father, in this pandemic. Almighty God, I pray even now that everyone who hears my voice may be convicted by the power of your Holy Spirit, that they may come to know you, Lord, whom to know is life eternal. Take our thoughts, our deeds, and our words captive unto the obedience of Jesus Christ, Son of the living God, and use us to declare your truth, your glory, and your faithfulness. As a result of Corona, Father, people are hurting. People are scared. People are sick. People are dying, and people are mourning. Father God, have mercy. Nations are under lockdown and some under curfew. Father, help us in this time of chaos. God, I declare today that you are our strength. You are our hope. Your promise, you promise, oh God, never to leave us or forsake us. And God, we claim that promise in the name of Jesus. 2 Timothy 1:7 declares that you have not given us a spirit of fear, but of power, of love, and of a sound mind. Help us, Lord, to exercise our faith in you and trust you, because we know that you are the same yesterday, today, and forever. And your promises are yea and amen. Father, in the midst of this turmoil and chaos, you are our peace, the peace that passes all understanding. God, help us to trust you to see us through. I plead the blood of Jesus on each of us, our families, the United States and British Virgin Islands, the Caribbean Islands, all 50 states, every nation, every continent, the four corners of this earth. The blood of Jesus will never lose its power. Thank you, Father, for that it reaches to the highest mountain and it flows to the lowest valley. And the blood that gives us strength from day to day will never, never, never lose its power. We plead your blood, Father, over this COVID-19 pandemic and trust you for deliverance. In Jesus' name, we surrender all to your will and to your way. God, grant us endurance and strengthen our faith so that we may stand in steadfast obedience. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. Jehovah has the final say.
So delighted this morning that we can, on behalf of the Seventh-day Adventist Church, join with the nation in seeking the face of the Lord at such a crucial and critical time in Earth's history. In a time when men's hearts are failing them for fear, we are so happy that we have an anchor that keeps the soul. And so this morning, we just want to join in concert in prayer to our mighty God so that he may heal our land. Let us pray. Almighty God, what an awesome God you are. There's none like you in the heaven and the earth. Heaven is thy home, but the earth is thy footstool. You are merciful, compassionate. You are God who is awesome, but yet you are accessible and available because you are God who are touch with the feelings of our infirmity. We come because our needs are many. We come because we are so puny, but you are so powerful. In the light of this virus that stalks our land, we realize that we are both hopeless and helpless. But we are so happy that in times like these, we have a God who is a mighty bulwark. He never fails, and we can call upon him, and we are confident that he will answer. He said in his word, if my people, which are called by my name, in the time of pestilence shall seek my face, that he will not only hear, but he will answer, and he will heal our land. And so this morning, Lord, we come before you. Nothing in our hands we bring. We cling to you who are God Almighty. We want to pray in a special way that you may manifest your presence and manifest your power in this nation. We seek your face because the virus brings death and fear and hopelessness. We look at us. And as a people, we are devastated, we are depressed, we are cast down. Oh Lord, we call upon you because hope is displaced, hope is misplaced, hope is replaced. And for many, life seems to be a hopeless end, but we're so happy with Jesus, we have an endless hope. And so we come to you this morning, realizing that you are a mighty fortress is our God, a bulwark never failing. Yes, we amidst the flood of mortal ills prevailing, that there's one answer, and that answer is sure, and it is on the rock, Christ Jesus. And so this morning we pray for our nation. We pray for our leaders, Lord, the men and women whom you've placed in authority, the governor and his entire leadership staff. Oh God, grant them the uncanny wisdom, that wisdom that they may seek your face and you may endow them with the right solutions, the best pathways, the best decisions. So as they adjudicate and make decisions in this critical time of challenge and crisis, there may be decisions that may lead to the health of our nation. Oh Lord, we pray for the many at the frontiers fighting this vicious battle. We pray for the doctors and the nurses and the first responders, those men and women who are sacrificially giving of their time and services and even giving the ultimate sacrifice of their lives because they love the service and they love the people. Oh Lord, the stench of death rises, and we hear the wail and the cries of pain and sickness and suffering. Oh God, you are a great mediator. You are a healer. And so come by here now and visit us. Walk among us and heal, restore. Give us hope. Give us the confidence that we can trust in our God. He's our refuge. You promised us that there will come a time when the immovable will move, but we are so confident that in Christ we have an answer. Bless us as a nation and as a people, and grant us an answer. Heal our land. In Jesus' name we ask it. Amen.
For us to pray and to understand that this is a time for us not to play. President George Washington said on the 17th day of October, 1789, he said that it is the duty of all nations that we must acknowledge the providence of God, to take note of his benefits that he has loaded with us daily, and to implore him in a time of need for favor and protection. This is indeed a time that governors have called for times of prayer and fasting and reflection. And we thank God today for our governor making this declaration and proclamation that today is a day that we ought to pray, fast, and reflect. I want to permit me just a few moments, if you can. If you go look in your words in your Bible, look at the scripture, Philippians chapter 4, verse 6. And there is where I want us to begin before we begin to pray. Philippians 4, chapter verse 6. And it states, be anxious for nothing, but in everything, by prayer and supplication, with thanksgiving, let your requests be made known unto God. Let's pray. God, indeed, right now we call on you, the God of mercy and the God of grace, that you allow mercy to triumph over judgment. We come right now knowing that we dwell under your shadow. We abide where you dwell. We come right now acknowledging, God, that we need you in this territory. We need you in this world. We need you in these, your nations. We thank you right now, God, for who you are, that you are able. You are able to do exceedingly, abundantly, above all that we can ask or even imagine. So God, right now we use the words that you've given us, spirit and life, to prophesy over dead bones. We speak even now to things that seems to be bland and without your spirit. And God, we enliven it with your word and with your truth. We come right now, God, declaring over this territory that you are the same God yesterday, today, and forevermore. We thank you that you are aware of what's happening every single moment. And God, right now, we call those things that be not. And we take this moment to give attention to you. You've called your people to humble themselves, to pray and to seek your face, and to turn from their wicked ways. And God, here we are today on bended knees. Here we are today with bowed hearts. Here we are today, God, to say, have your way. God, we're praying a covering even now over the minds and the heads of your leaders, that your leaders will begin to walk in the light and that they will lead justly. God, we take not this moment to say we checked off a box, but God, we come to call on your name. We are here proclaiming that Jesus is King, that Jesus is Lord, that Jesus is Healer, that Jesus is Sustainer. And God, we thank you for what you are doing. We let our request be made known unto you, because you say, if we ask anything in your name according to your will, that will you do. So God, right now we speak blessings over this land, that there's no virus, no plague that shall come nigh our dwelling. We are established in righteousness, so oppression is far from us. We declare today, if we be your children, you will cover us, you will keep us, you will make sure that you direct our paths. So God, we thank you today for what the governor has stated, that the health care providers, the caregivers, that they're covered and protected by you. We do not deserve it, but God, you saw fit to give us another opportunity to come into your presence and to pull on your virtue of healing. So heal us once again. Create in us a clean heart and renew a right spirit within us. So God, we say, oh, you are able. You are able. You are able. Yes, you are. You're so able, God. And we thank you for who you are and what you have been doing. If we can sing it as a territory. Oh. Come on, declare it out of your mouth. He's able. Come on, come on, let's sing it.
Your name, we decree and we declare that there's none like you. And Father God, you tell us in your word we are to give you back your word. And Father God, I give you your word from the book of 2 Chronicles, and I begin at verse 13. You tell us, God, if you shut up heaven that there be no rain, or if you command the locusts to deliver the land, or if you send pestilence among your people, you said, if your people, which are called by your name, shall humble themselves and pray and seek your face and turn from our wicked ways. Then you said, Lord, you will hear from heaven and will forgive our sins and heal our land. Father God, you gave us opportunity to choose right from wrong by telling us if. So Father, I thank you for Governor. I thank you for his cabinet members. I thank you for President, because you said we are to pray for those that have the rule over us. Father God, I pray for the spiritual leaders, not only in the Virgin Islands, but around the world. And I'm thanking you in advance, God, that you're not only hearing, but I believe by faith that you have already sent the answer. In your word, when Daniel prayed, immediately the answer came, but it was held back by the wicked portion. Father God, many have prayed prior to me, and I come to you now as Daddy God, on behalf of the entire Virgin Islands, the Caribbean Islands, and the entire world. And first of all, Daddy God, we ask you to forgive us. We have done wrong. We acknowledge our faults. And you promise if we will continue to do what you tell us to do, you will hear our prayer. Father and God, this virus, this disease, call it what we may, we know, Father God, that the answer, the healing is already there. So now we ask that you will dispatch your warring angels to go to wherever, whether in the Virgin Islands or where, and just like Jesus, your son, did, snatch the key. Snatch Kutama, snatch from the enemy the medication, the wisdom, the whatever that is needed, God, to take this virus away from the world. Because it's not only one area, it's the entire earth that is suffering. Father and eternal God, I stand here, God, and holy on my knees, God. I stand as the attorney on behalf of those that would see or hear what your Holy Spirit is speaking through me. And I plead my case to you, Daddy God. I've come to you many times before, and you answered. You heard and you answered. And here I am again, God, pleading the case for the Virgin Islands, for your people, oh God, concerning the pain and the suffering, the fear, God, that your people are fearing. But I give you your word back. You promise us that fear is not of you. You promise us, Daddy God, that if we pray, you would answer. You would hear and you would answer. So, Father God, go to every home, every hospital, every institution. And I'm asking you by faith, believing that the cure is already there. Open up the eyes of the doctors and the scientists and the other big names that I can't call. But you know them, Daddy God. And I'm not going to give you any date. But God, I'm believing that soon and very soon, we will begin to see the change. You are God. There's none like you. You have made us all. And you said, Daddy God, that you don't wish for any to suffer. Daddy God, you see the suffering. Even the babies, oh God, are suffering. The elders like myself are suffering. Elders. God, you said that you are jealous concerning the widows. In your word, you said, suffer the little children to come unto me and forbid them not, for such is the kingdom of God. So, Father God, I thank you that when Moses, your man, that you sent to Pharaoh and you told Pharaoh, let my people go. And Pharaoh said, go, then he changed his mind. But he was touched when his son got touched. I speak to that coronavirus now in the name of Jesus the Christ. I take authority over you because my God told me he has given me power and authority, his power and his authority. And I take it now and I wield it against that virus. And I speak to you in the name of Jesus. And I go to the root cause. And I command you to dry up. I command you to leave this earth. This earth is not yours, devil. The blood of Jesus Christ of Nazareth is against you. My God, he tells you he's given us power and authority. So I have the authority to tell you where to go. Go back from whence you came in the name of Jesus. And set the people of God free. I know there are many that are scared. I know that there are many that are sad. I have lost loved ones. And I know what it is to lose a loved one. But I want to say today to all that's listening to my voice, just a few lines of a wonderful song that you all know. What a friend we have in Jesus. All our sins and griefs to bear. What a privilege to carry everything. Everything, including coronavirus, to God in prayer. I pray for our governor again. I pray for his cabinet. I pray for the people of these Virgin Islands. I pray for these people around the world. And I encourage you. God is not only able, he's also willing. And by faith, I am believing that soon, and very soon, we're going to hear it. They are going to say that they have found the cure, but we know that God is the one, and God alone is the one to give us the cure. Don't give up. Don't give in. Keep on praying. In Jesus' name, amen.
A lot of people don't realize how dangerous speeding can be. The lower limits you see posted in neighborhoods are there for a reason. So when the unexpected happens, you have time to stop. Because even 5 or 10 miles over the limit can mean the difference between a near miss and to hit. Stop speeding before it stops you.
Muchas personas no se dan cuenta del peligro de conducir a alta velocidad. Los límites de velocidad reducidos en las zonas escolares están ahí por una razón, para que cuando ocurra algo inesperado, usted se pueda detener a tiempo. Porque así sean 5 o 10 millas sobre el límite de velocidad, eso puede ser la diferencia entre poder evitar o no poder evitar un choque. Reduzca la velocidad antes de que sea demasiado tarde.
Good morning. Thank you, each and every one of you, for joining us today in a time of fasting, reflection, and most of all, prayer. This is a troubling time in our world, and indeed a troubling time in our territory. But in all the troubles we have seen together, we have always known that there is a great Father above that guides our every move. And every single day we ask Him for guidance in getting through the simple things. Now we have a great task before us, the task of getting our people through this most horrific worldwide pandemic. But we trust and we have faith that He is with us and He walks with us. And this is a time that He has set aside for us to look at what we're doing, look at the lives we're leading, look at our neighbor, our community, our children, and find time to reflect on how we can do and what we can do to make life a little better. And as we sit today and think about the goodness of the Virgin Islands and the Lord and all that He has provided for us, it is also a time to be thankful and grateful for all that we do have to combat this pandemic. Through all the things that we have been through, the one thing that we have been able to count on is each other. And we too must reflect on the bonds that hold this community together, that keep us tight, that gives us the love and the strength of a community, that helps us to raise our children, to get along day by day, to relish in our diversity, and to overcome all of the tribulations and the trials that come before us. Today is but one day of a long, arduous road we have as we make it through this worldwide pandemic. But I trust that the God above gives me, you, and the entire Virgin Islands, the wisdom, the perseverance, and the get-go to get up every single day and do the things that are needed to get our community through this. I'd really like to thank everyone and our staff and in the community that made today a success, and all of the pastors of different faith that have shown up here today to add a little bit of love, light, and mostly hope to a very dark situation. We, over the weekend, we went over several Psalms, and the wife and I, Yolanda, decided on one that would be fitting for this appropriate and comforting for all ages. So I asked her to join me now as she says this, recites this psalm for you, Yolanda.
Thank you, Governor. And to that I say, amen. Greetings, Virgin Islands. Today I will be reading from the book of Psalms, chapters 91, verse 1 through 11, and it reads, "Whoever dwells in the shelter of the Most High will rest in the shadow of the Almighty. I will say of the Lord, He is my refuge and my fortress, my God, in whom I trust. Surely He will save you from the fowler's snare and from the deadly pestilence. He will cover you with His feathers, and under His wings you will find refuge. His faithfulness will be your shield and rampart. You will not fear the terror of night, nor the arrow that flies by day, nor the pestilence that stalks in the darkness, nor the plague that destroys at midday. 1,000 may fall at your side, 10,000 at your right hand, but it will not come near you. You will only observe with your eyes and see the punishment of the wicked. If you say, 'The Lord is my refuge,' and you make the Most High your dwelling, no harm will overtake you, nor disaster will come near your tent. He will command His angels concerning you to guard you in all your ways." The word of God. Amen.
As I leave you today, I ask you to pray for us as I pray for you. Pray for the leaders of the territory. Pray for the legislature, the delegate. And pray for all the leaders in our community that are directors, managers, supervisors. Pray for the healthcare workers that have to come out and brave against this horrible pandemic. Pray for the police officers, the EMTs, the first responders, the people that are delivering our packages, the people that are packing the grocery stores with shelves, with food, all the people that are making it happen and coming out here and risking not only their safety, but the safety of their families to make sure that we make it one more day. God bless you, and God bless the Virgin Islands.
I'm really humbled to be here today. Thank you so much, Governor, for allowing us this opportunity as a people to come before God in this season of immense difficulty and trials. You know, today, before I even begin to pray, I want to invite you to turn with me, if you're at home, in the book of 2 Chronicles chapter 7. I just want to read two quick scriptures for us this morning. These are the words directly from God. 2 Chronicles chapter 7 and verse number 13 declares, hallelujah, when I shut up the heavens so that there be no rain, and command locusts to devour the land, or send a plague among my people, if my people who are called by my name shall humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, then will I hear from heaven and forgive their sins and heal their land. Would you bow with me this time as we look to God for our help? Heavenly Father, in the name of Jesus, I come before you, God. We come before you today, dear God, not to demand anything of you, O God, but just to ask, O God. Father, we are humble. This plague, O God, this situation, this virus, O God, has brought us to our knees today, dear God. And Lord, in our own strength, we are nothing, O God. In our own strength, O God, we can do nothing. So, Father, we understand today that we need you now more than ever before, dear God. Lord, all over the world, people are hurting. People are dying, oh God. People are in desperate need. But your word declares, God, if my people who are called by my name, dear God, will humble themselves. And right now, God, we humble ourselves before you. Because you are God, and unlike you, other than you, dear God, is no other God. And Father, we bow in your presence. We say to you, dear God, to have mercy upon us, dear God. Lord, we don't deserve it, oh God, because it's a nation. We have turned our back from you, O God. As our nation, O God, we have gone after our own selfish desires, O God, our own selfish lust. But today, O God, this very day, in the name of Jesus, O God, we repent of our sins, dear God, and we ask your mercy, we ask your forgiveness, we ask your healing, we ask your cleansing on this land. God, I thank you so much for our governor, O God, who saw fit to call all these people together, O God, to basically storm the throne room of heaven. Oh God, I pray that you will bless him. I pray that you will strengthen him. I pray that you will uphold him with your right hand, oh God. Bless his wife, oh First Lady, oh God. Cover her. Cover them, oh God. Our Lieutenant Governor, oh God. Strengthen him where he stands. God, so many are going over and beyond to see this happen, oh God. To see people, oh God, be tested. To see people be treated, oh God. Father, in the name of Jesus, I'm even asking you right now to bless every member of the healthcare department, oh God, that labor day and night, oh God, that toil to be there for our people. The members, oh God, of the legislative branch, oh God, strengthen them, oh God. Every member of cabinet, oh God, I bring them before you, oh God, because this is some trying times, oh God. This is some difficult times, oh God. Lord, the judicial branch, oh God, we ask that you will cover them, oh God, and every single citizen, every single person living in this Virgin Islands, oh God, especially, God, I remember the elderly that are in fear right now. Oh God, cover our elderly people. Strengthen them, dear God. I even ask right now, God, that you will encourage their hearts. Help them to look to you, God, the author and the finisher of our faith. And I pray, oh God, that anybody who does not know you as a personal Lord and Savior, that today, oh God, they will come to you and turn their hearts wholeheartedly to you. We give you all the praise. We give you all the glory. And we thank you that very soon, oh God, we will see healing. That very soon, dear God, we will see deliverance. And very soon, oh God, Lord, there will be a vaccine for this virus. And we will be able to look back and say, look what God has done. We thank you. And I ask all these things in Jesus' name. Amen.
Virgin Islanders, let us pray. Lord God, the merciful and compassionate Father of us all, our peace and our strength, today we pray for our territory as we face this pandemic, our nation, and the world. God, our healer, show your compassion for the whole human family. Come to our aid with your strong arm and your healing presence. Heal those who are sick. Support and protect their families and friends from being infected. Be present to all who mourn their dead. Give them courage and strength and faith to meet the days ahead. Comfort those around the world who cannot bury their dead. Bless physicians, nurses, and all others who minister to the sick and suffering. Keep them safe and healthy, and grant them wisdom and skill, sympathy and patience. Inspire and give insight and hope to all researchers focused on developing a vaccine and other life-saving medications and devices. Give wisdom, creativity, and perseverance to all researchers, policymakers, and leaders as they respond to this pandemic. Send down upon our President, Congress, and political leaders here in the Virgin Islands and everywhere the spirit of wisdom and charity and justice, that they may faithfully promote the well-being of all people. Guide them in finding and developing the resources and the political will to contain and finally end this pandemic. Guide leaders to speak the truth, halt the spread of misinformation, and act with justice. We pray for those who are quarantined or stranded away from home, for those who've lost employment, for those filled with fear, for those who don't know how to pay the rent, buy food, medications, and deal with double WABA bills. We pray for children who cannot go to school and for parents who need child care. For those who seek care in overwhelmed hospitals and clinics. For the physicians, nurses, and healthcare workers in those facilities. For care workers at the limits of their power to help. Healing God, come to all in need. Unbind those held by anxiety, despair, or pain. House this mentally ill and homeless in safe places. Show us how to provide assistance for those who suffer, if in no other way than with our prayers. Heal our world, heal our bodies, strengthen our hearts and our minds, and amid the turmoil, give us hope and peace. Hold us in your gentle embrace. Hold especially all those who have died and who will die this day. Comfort their loved ones in their despair. O Lord God, as we turn to you for help, look upon us with compassion and hear the fervent prayers of your people. For we pray in the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Assalamu alaikum. Peace and blessing of our Creator upon all of you. On my name and the name of the Muslims community in this island, we want to thank the governor and all the people that they make this gathering happen. And we want to congratulate our governor and those who come with this idea to join us together in a spiritual meeting that bring all our feeling together for the goodness of our island and the entire globe. First of all, my message is, we are gathering here to ask our Creator to make it, to release this situation from us as a human being. And the Creator will never release a situation from us, or will never change the situation around us unless we change ourselves. So we need to start with ourselves. We come here to pray. And prayer is not something that we use as a tool or an instrument when we are facing calamities in our life. And when we have difficulties, we just flee to our Creator. This should be a habit that we should have in daily basis. I will start my prayer with the first part of the Holy Quran, which is the first chapter in the Quran. I will read it in Arabic, then I will translate it in English. A'udhu billahi minash shaytanir rajim. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين. In the name of Allah, the Creator, the Merciful, the Most Merciful, all praises are due to our Creator. الرحمن الرحيم. The merciful, the most merciful. مالك يوم الدين. The owner of the day of judgment. إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين. You only we worship, and from you only we seek help. اهدنا الصراط المستقيم. Guide us to the straight path. صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. Guide us to the straight path, the path of those who you bestowed, not the path of those who gain your anger, nor the path of those who go astray. We pray to our Creator to relieve this situation from our island and from the entire globe. Amen.
Yes, greetings, peace and love to all the citizens of the Virgin Islands, to our brothers and sisters in the Caribbean, them on the mainland, South America, Asia, Europe, Africa. Send a perfect love, peace, unity unto all of us in the global family of humanity. From the theocracy reign of the ancient divine art of the Nyabingi, we send out our prayers to the Father, to the Mother of creation for healing and His mercy. Abakidus, Samen Fiskidus, Tikurdam Lak. Give thanks and praises. Abatachinoi Besima Yemet Nord, Semiakudes Mengustimta, Fakadi Besima in the Honechin to Hubemeditun. Yelitin jada sitting zari, better la chinin in your kid billion in yan, yabu lemon in your kid in diminil, with a fitetna matagban, kikafikulu adin in engi, mangus yantinatina, hailin, miskenam lezele clemo. Our Father who dwells among Zion, blessed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in Mount Zion. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those that trespass against us. Allow us not to go into temptation, but deliver us from all evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory belongs unto the Most High from that time to this time and forevermore. Yes, prince and princesses, we must come out of Babylon. Ethiopians, we shall stretch forth our hands unto our divine majesty, Emperor Haile Selassie I and Empress Menin Asfa of Ethiopia. Thy spirit tread within I and I to dwell in the paths of righteousness. For thy name's sake, lead I and I. Help I and I to forgive that I and I may be forgiven. Teach I and I love, loyalty, and earth as it is in Mount Zion. Endow within I and I wise mind, knowledge, and overstanding to do thy will. Thy blessings to I and I, that the hungry be fed, the naked clothed, the sick nourished, the aged protected, and the infants cared for. Deliver I and I from the hands of I and I enemies, that we may prove fruitful even in these perilous days. As I and I enemies are past and decayed, in the depths of the seas, in the depths of the earth, even in the belly of the beast. Grant unto I and I all a place within the ever-living kingdom, through the powers of the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords, the conquering Lion of the tribe of Judah, the elect of the Almighty, as the light of this world. And I, divine majesty, Emperor Haile Selassie I, the first king of Iration, the Alpha, Empress Menin, the Omega, the beginning without end, first and forever, protectorate of I and I life, I and I faith, and the ruler of this universe. So we hail unto the Most High, hail I, Selassie I the first. O great and thunderable I, hail I, Selassie I the first. Holy omnipotent I, hail I, Selassie I the first. Yes, O Heavenly Father and Mother of creation, have mercy upon us. Forgive humanity of their transgression that they have committed against you. Yes, restore perfect love, restore balance in creation and in humanity, that we may show perfect love one to another. We may be our brother's keeper, our sister's keeper. We may be one family, the human family which we all belong to, regardless of color, race, creed, or denomination. For there is one Father and one Mother of creation. So we ask thee, I humbly, please have mercy upon us and forgive humanity of their transgression. Let the words of I and I mouth, the meditations of I and I heart, let the humble be acceptable in thy sight, O Emperor Haile Selassie I and Empress Menin Asfa. For they are good towards man, humanity, and thy love shall I store us. Peace and love. Selah.
God bless everybody. Thank you for the opportunity, Governor, to be part of this event. I'm representing the Spanish community. Dios bendiga de manera especial todo el que nos escucha a través de estas redes sociales. Es una bendición para nosotros poder estar aquí presente declarando una palabra de vida, una palabra de esperanza, una palabra de fe para todo aquel que nos escucha en esta hora. Dice el Salmo 9 en el verso 9: será el eterno fortaleza del oprimido, fortaleza para los momentos de sufrimiento. Confían en él todos los que conocen su nombre, porque tú no has abandonado a los que te buscan. Hay tres cosas esenciales en la palabra del Señor a través de este Salmo. Número uno, él es refugio. Número dos, él es fortaleza. Y número tres, él es nuestra confianza. Solamente a través de Jesús tenemos salvación y vida eterna. Él es nuestro Señor y Salvador. Reconocemos la presencia de él para poder llegar a la presencia del Padre. Y en esta preciosa tarde vamos a hacer una oración para que el Eterno pueda guiarnos a través de esta situación difícil que todas las naciones estamos experimentando. Padre, te damos gracias, Señor, en esta tarde. En el nombre de Jesús venimos a tu presencia, Dios Padre, porque sabemos, Señor, que tú habitas en luz inaccesible, habitas en tu trono. Pero aunque estás sentado, Señor, tienes control de todo lo que surge a través de la naturaleza, Padre. Tú no estás en cuarentena, Señor. Tú estás en medio de todo el proceso que estamos experimentando. Por eso en esta tarde te pedimos que tu presencia, Señor, pueda llegar aún a nuestro gobierno, Señor, para darle sabiduría en momentos donde tendrá que tomar decisiones fuertes. Te pedimos, Señor, también por todo ese equipo de trabajo que está al frente de la guerra, los enfermeros, los doctores, todos los que componen el equipo que está trabajando fuertemente para enfrentar esta situación. También te presentamos, Señor, a cada una de las personas que están siendo afectadas en estos momentos. Personas, Señor, en momentos de desesperación, de ansiedad, donde sus emociones quizás están siendo afectadas, Padre, porque muchos de ellos tendrán que enfrentar la muerte. Yo te pido, Señor, que como tú estuviste con tu hijo, tú seas sustento a todo aquel que en este momento tiene esa necesidad. Sé refugio, sé fortaleza, Señor. Sé confianza para aquellos que nos escuchan en esta hora y que quizás están desesperados, están angustiados, están temerosos, están llenos de miedo, Señor. Yo te pido, Señor, que tú, a través de tu Hijo Jesús, puedas llegarte a cada hogar, a cada lugar, a cada vida, Señor, para que puedas llegar ahí y dar la paz que todos necesitamos. Tú dices en tu palabra que tú nos das tu paz, una paz que el mundo no puede dar, porque no proviene del mundo, proviene de tú, proviene de ti, que experimentaste todo lo que nosotros experimentamos. Por eso te pedimos en esta hora, Señor, que seas tú cubriendo, Dios, a todo aquel que está en necesidad en esta hora, Señor. Te pedimos, Señor, que tú seas obrando de manera especial, Padre, aún donde nosotros no podemos llegar, por medio, Señor, de la palabra, por medio de un mensaje, por medio, Señor, de lo que podamos experimentar. Te doy gracias en esta hora, Señor, y te pido por nuestra isla y las vírgenes, Santa Cruz, San Tomás y Sañón, que tú bendigas nuestras islas y que bendigas nuestra nación. En el nombre de Jesús oramos. Amén y amén.
Let us pray. God Almighty, we humble ourselves in your presence even now. We acknowledge, God, that you are the great I am. We acknowledge that you are sovereign of this universe. We acknowledge that you are omnipotent, omnipresent, and omniscient. We acknowledge that, God, you are God all by yourself, and hallelujah, there is absolutely none like you. You are the Lord and Master of all that you survey. You are Jehovah Jireh, Jehovah Nissi, Jehovah Sitkenu, Jehovah Shammah, Jehovah Shalom. Light of the world, you step down into our darkness. God, open our eyes that we may see you clearly. Open our ears that we may hear and obey. God, in spite of ourselves, you love us with an everlasting love. And you have called us to love each other as you have loved us. Oh, how we have failed you, God. We have dishonored you in our thoughts and our words and our deeds. In this Lenten season, you are calling us to repentance. We recognize that your wrath has been kindled against us, and you have called your entire universe to attention. You have turned this world upside down, yet we are defiant. Father, forgive us. We acknowledge that you have the whole world in your hands and that you've been speaking to us long before COVID-19, 9/11, wars and rumors of wars, mudslides and earthquakes in diverse places, destructive fires, devastating hurricanes, yet our ears are filled with wax so we cannot hear. Father, forgive us. You have called us to a global quarantine, given us time to acknowledge the folly of our ways and to recognize that, oh God, you are still on the throne, yet we defy the order to exercise social distancing and refuse to stay at home for our own safety and for the safety of those you have called us to love. You have given us guidelines through the governor, CDC, and our health authorities, and some are not taking these seriously. God, forgive us. We thank you for the leadership of Governor Bryan and his cabinet, members of the legislature, and those on the front lines. God, bless them and strengthen them for the days ahead. Help us to recognize your voice, Father, in this pandemic. Almighty God, I pray even now that everyone who hears my voice may be convicted by the power of your Holy Spirit, that they may come to know you, Lord, whom to know is life eternal. Take our thoughts, our deeds, and our words captive unto the obedience of Jesus Christ, Son of the living God, and use us to declare your truth, your glory, and your faithfulness. As a result of Corona, Father, people are hurting. People are scared. People are sick. People are dying, and people are mourning. Father God, have mercy. Nations are under lockdown and some under curfew. Father, help us in this time of chaos. God, I declare today that you are our strength. You are our hope. Your promise, you promise, oh God, never to leave us or forsake us. And God, we claim that promise in the name of Jesus. 2 Timothy 1:7 declares that you have not given us a spirit of fear, but of power, of love, and of a sound mind. Help us, Lord, to exercise our faith in you and trust you, because we know that you are the same yesterday, today, and forever. And your promises are yea and amen. Father, in the midst of this turmoil and chaos, you are our peace, the peace that passes all understanding. God, help us to trust you to see us through. I plead the blood of Jesus on each of us, our families, the United States and British Virgin Islands, the Caribbean Islands, all 50 states, every nation, every continent, the four corners of this earth. The blood of Jesus will never lose its power. Thank you, Father, for that it reaches to the highest mountain and it flows to the lowest valley. And the blood that gives us strength from day to day will never lose its power. We plead your blood, Father, over this COVID-19 pandemic and trust you for deliverance. In Jesus' name, we surrender all to your will and to your way. God, grant us endurance and strengthen our faith so that we may stand in steadfast obedience. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. Jehovah has the final say.
So delighted this morning that we can, on behalf of the Seventh-day Adventist Church, join with the nation in seeking the face of the Lord at such a crucial and critical time in Earth's history. In a time when men's hearts are failing them for fear, we are so happy that we have an anchor that keeps the soul. And so this morning, we just want to join in concert in prayer to our mighty God so that he may heal our land. Let us pray. Almighty God, what an awesome God you are. There's none like you in the heaven and the earth. Heaven is thy home, but the earth is thy footstool. You are merciful, compassionate. You are God who is awesome, but yet you are accessible and available. because you're God who are touched with the feelings of our infirmity. We come because our needs are many. We come because we are so puny, but you are so powerful. In the light of this virus that stalks our land, we realize that we are both hopeless and helpless. But we are so happy that in times like these, we have a God who is a mighty bulwark. He never fails, and we can call upon him, and we are confident that he will answer. He said in his word, if my people, which are called by my name, in the time of pestilence shall seek my face, that he will not only hear, but he will answer, and he will heal our land. And so this morning, Lord, we come before you. Nothing in our hands we bring. We cling to you, who are God Almighty. We want to pray in a special way that you may manifest your presence and manifest your power in this nation. We seek your face because the virus brings death and fear and hopelessness. We look at us, and as a people, we are devastated. We are depressed. We are cast down. Oh, Lord, we call upon you because hope is displaced. Hope is misplaced. Hope is replaced. And for many, life seems to be a hopeless end, but we're so happy with Jesus, we have an endless hope. And so we come to you this morning, realizing that you are a mighty fortress, is our God, a bulwark never failing. Yes, we amidst the flood of mortal ills prevailing, that there's one answer, and that answer is sure, and it is on the rock, Christ Jesus. And so this morning, we pray for our nation. We pray for our leaders, Lord, the men and women whom you have placed in authority, the governor and his entire leadership staff. Oh God, grant them the uncanny wisdom, that wisdom that they may seek your face and you may endow them with the right solutions, the best pathways, the best decisions. So as they adjudicate and make decisions in this critical time of challenge and crisis, there may be decisions that may lead to the health of our nation. Oh Lord, we pray for the many at the frontiers fighting this vicious battle. We pray for the doctors and the nurses and the first responders, those men and women who are sacrificially giving of their time and services and even giving the ultimate sacrifice of their lives because they love the service and they love the people. Oh Lord, the stench of death rises, and we hear the wail and the cries of pain and sickness and suffering. Oh God, you are a great mediator. You are a healer. And so come by here now and visit us. Walk among us and heal, restore. Give us hope. Give us the confidence that we can trust in our God. He's our refuge. You promised us that there will come a time when the immovable will move, but we are so confident that in Christ we have an answer. Bless us as a nation and as a people, and grant us an answer. Heal our land. In Jesus' name we ask it. Amen.
Us to pray and to understand that this is a time for us not to play. President George Washington said on the 17th day of October, 1789, he said that it is the duty of all nations that we must acknowledge the providence of God, to take note of his benefits that he has loaded with us daily, and and to implore him in a time of need for favor and protection. This is indeed a time that governors have called for times of prayer and fasting and reflection. And we thank God today for our governor making this declaration and proclamation that today is a day that we ought to pray, fast, and reflect. I want to permit me just a few moments, if you can. If you go look in your words in your Bible, look at the scripture, Philippians chapter 4, verse 6. And there is where I want us to begin before we begin to pray. Philippians 4, chapter verse 6. And it states, be anxious for nothing, but in everything, by prayer and supplication, with thanksgiving, let your requests be made known unto God. Let's pray. God, indeed, right now we call on you, the God of mercy and the God of grace, that you allow mercy to triumph over judgment. We come right now knowing that we dwell under your shadow. We abide where you dwell. We come right now acknowledging, God, that we need you in this territory. We need you in this world. We need you in these your nations. We thank you right now, God, for who you are, that you are able. You are able to do exceedingly, abundantly, above all that we can ask or even imagine. So God, right now we use the words that you've given us, spirit and life, to prophesy over dead bones. We speak even now to things that seems to be bland and without your spirit. And God, we enliven it with your word and with your truth. We come right now, God, declaring over this territory that you are the same God yesterday, today, and forevermore. We thank you that you are aware of what's happening every single moment. And God, right now we call those things that be not, and we take this moment to give attention to you. You've called your people to humble themselves, to pray and to seek your face, and to turn from their wicked ways. And God, here we are today on bended knees. Here we are today with bowed hearts. Here we are today, God, to say, have your way. God, we're praying a covering even now over the minds and the heads of your leaders, that your leaders will begin to walk in the light and that they will lead justly. God, we take not this moment to say we checked off a box, but God, we come to call on your name. We are here proclaiming that Jesus is King, that Jesus is Lord, that Jesus is Healer, that Jesus is Sustainer. And God, we thank you for what you are doing. We let our request be made known unto you, because you say if we ask anything in your name according to your will, that will you do. So God, right now we speak blessings over this land, that there's no virus, no plague that shall come nigh our dwelling. We are established in righteousness, so oppression is far from us. We declare today, if we be your children, you will cover us, you will keep us, you will make sure that you direct our paths. So God, we thank you today for what the governor has stated, that the healthcare providers, the caregivers, that they're covered and protected by you. We do not deserve it, but God, you saw fit to give us another opportunity to come into your presence and to pull on your virtue of healing. So heal us once again. Create in us a clean heart and renew a right spirit within us. So God, we say, oh, you are able. You are able. You are able. Yes, you are. You're so able, God. And we thank you for who you are and what you have been doing. If we can sing it as a territory. Oh. Come on, declare it out of your mouth. He's able. Come on, come on, let's sing it. Thank you.
Hallelujah. We bless you, Lord. We glorify your name. We decree and we declare that there's none like you. Father God, you tell us in your word, we are to give you back your word. Father God, I give you your word from the book of 2 Chronicles. And I begin at verse 13. You tell us, God, if you shut up heaven, that there be no rain, or if you command the locusts to deliver the land, or if you send pestilence among your people. You said, if your people, which are called by your name, shall humble themselves and pray and seek your face and turn from our wicked ways, then you said, Lord, you will hear from heaven and will forgive our sins and heal our land. Father God, you gave us opportunity to choose right from wrong by telling us if. So Father, I thank you for our governor. I thank you for his cabinet members. I thank you for president, because you said we are to pray for those that have the rule over us. Father God, I pray for the spiritual leaders, not only in the Virgin Islands, but around the world. And I'm thanking you in advance, God, that you're not only hearing, but I believe by faith that you have already sent the answer. In your word, when Daniel prayed, immediately the answer came, but it was held back by the wicked portion. Father God, many have prayed prior to me, and I come to you now as Daddy God, on behalf of the entire Virgin Islands, the Caribbean Islands, and the entire world. And first of all, Daddy God, we ask you to forgive us. We have done wrong. We acknowledge our faults. And you promise, if we will continue to do what you tell us to do, you will hear our prayer. Father and God, there's virus, there's disease, call it what we may. We know, Father God, that the answer, the healing is already there. So now we ask that you will dispatch your warring angels to go to wherever, whether in the Virgin Islands or where, and just like Jesus, your son, did, snatch the key, snatch Kutama, snatch from the enemy the medication, the wisdom, the whatever that is needed, God, to take this virus away from the world. Because it's not only one area, it's the entire earth that is suffering. Father and eternal God, I stand here, God, in holy, on my knees, God. I stand as the attorney on behalf of those that would see or hear what your Holy Spirit is speaking through me. And I plead my case to you, Daddy God. I've come to you many times before, and you answered. You heard and you answered. And here I am again, God, pleading the case for the Virgin Islands, for your people, oh God, concerning the pain and the suffering, the fear, God, that your people are fearing. But I give you your word back. You promise us that fear is not of you. You promise us, Daddy God, that if we pray, you would answer, you would hear, and you would answer. So, Father God, go to every home, every hospital, every institution. And I'm asking you by faith, believing that the cure is already there. Open up the eyes of the doctors and the scientists and the other big names that I can't call. But you know them, Daddy God. And I'm not going to give you any date. But God, I'm believing that soon and very soon, we will begin to see the change. You are God. There's none like you. You have made us all. And you said, Daddy God, that you don't wish for any to suffer. Daddy God, you see the suffering. Even the babies, oh God, are suffering. The elders like myself are suffering. Elders. God, you said that you are jealous concerning the widows. In your word, you said, suffer the little children to come unto me and forbid them not, for such is the kingdom of God. So, Father God, I thank you that when Moses, your man, that you sent to Pharaoh and you told Pharaoh, let my people go. And Pharaoh said, go, then he changed his mind. But he was touched when his son got touched. I speak to that coronavirus now in the name of Jesus the Christ. Authority over you, because my God told me he has given me power and authority, his power and his authority, and I take it now and I wield it against that virus, and I speak to you in the name of Jesus, and I go to the root cause, and I command you to dry up. I command you to leave this earth. This earth is not yours, devil. The blood of Jesus Christ of Nazareth is against you. My God, he tells you he's given us power and authority. So I have the authority to tell you where to go. Go back from whence you came in the name of Jesus. And set the people of God free. I know there are many that are scared. I know that there are many that are sad. I have lost loved ones. And I know what it is to lose a loved one. But I want to say today to all that's listening to my voice, just a few lines of a wonderful song that you all know. What a friend we have in Jesus. All our sins and griefs to bear. What a privilege to carry everything. Everything, including coronavirus, to for God in prayer. I pray for our governor again. I pray for his cabinet. I pray for the people of these Virgin Islands. I pray for these people around the world. And I encourage you, God is not only able, he's also willing. And by faith, I am believing that soon, and very soon, we're going to hear it. They're going to say that they have found the cure, but we know that God is the one, and God alone is the one to give us the cure. Don't give up. Don't give in. Keep on praying. In Jesus' name, amen.
Can I have 2 fried chicken legs, 4 Johnny cake, and a rum and coke? Or and 2 slices of chocolate cake, 1 for now and 1 for later.
Nadia, you really gonna eat all of that? You need to make better food choices. Heart disease runs in our family. Grandma got high blood pressure, and Uncle Billy just had a stroke.
Well, I young and I don't exercise 2 days a week.
That is not enough.
Managing heart disease might be difficult, but with better choices and healthier living, we can get through it. Avoid overeating. A balanced diet in the right proportions can reduce the risk of heart disease. Exercise at least 30 minutes per day, 3 times a week. Make it a lifestyle. Virgin Islands vital statistics data shows that heart disease is one of the leading causes of death in the territory. For more ways you can reduce the risk of heart disease, visit the DOH office today.
Imagine these 2 crash dummies were your children in the backseat of your car here in the Virgin Islands. One in an approved child safety seat, the other in just the backseat. If your children were in a car crash, they'd be a whole lot safer in a child-approved safety seat. We asked Grandmaster Everett Charles to demonstrate for us what would happen to the child in the backseat of a car in a crash by using a watermelon. The Grandmaster proves it. Child-approved safety seats save lives. Don't let your baby be a watermelon.
Mama, Papa, please sit down.
Hey, Virgin Islands, drop me in.
This message from the VI Office of Highway Safety through funds provided by the National Transportation Highway Safety Agency. It's the hottest after party in the Virgin Islands. To get in, all you need is car keys and a drink. Isn't this one after party you can skip? This message from the VI Office of Highway Safety through funds provided by the National Transportation Highway Safety Agency.
Good morning. Thank you, each and every one of you, for joining us today in a time of fasting, reflection, and most of all, prayer. This is a troubling time in our world, and indeed a troubling time in our territory. But in all the troubles we have seen together, we have always known that there is a great Father above that guides our every move. And every single day we ask Him for guidance in getting through the simple things. And now we have a great task before us, the task of getting our people through this most horrific worldwide pandemic. But we trust and we have faith that He is with us and He walks with us. And this is a time that He has set aside for us to look at what we're doing, look at the lives we're leading, look at our neighbor, our community, our children, and find time to reflect on how we can do and what we can do to make life a little better. And as we sit today and think about the goodness of the Virgin Islands and the Lord and all that He has provided for us, it is also a time to be thankful and grateful for all that we do have to combat this pandemic. Through all the things that we have been through, the one thing that we have been able to count on is each other. And we too must reflect on the bonds that hold this community together, that keep us tight, that gives us the love and the strength of a community, that helps us to raise our children, to get along day by day, to relish in our diversity, and to overcome all of the tribulations and the trials that come before us. Today is but one day of a long, arduous road we have as we make it through this worldwide pandemic. But I trust that the God above gives me, you, and the entire Virgin Islands, the wisdom, the perseverance, and the get-go to get up every single day and do the things that are needed to get our community through this. I really like to thank everyone and our staff and in the community that made today a success, and all of the pastors of different faith that have shown up here today to add a little bit of love, light, and mostly hope to a very dark situation. We, over the weekend, we went over several Psalms, and the wife and I, Yolanda, decided on one that would be fitting for this appropriate and comforting for all ages. So I ask her to join me now as she says this, recites this psalm for you, Yolanda.
Thank you, Governor. And to that I say, amen. Greetings, Virgin Islands. Today I will be reading from the book of Psalms, chapters 91, verse 1 through 11. And it reads, whoever dwells in the shelter of the Most High will rest in the shadow of the Almighty. I will say of the Lord, He is my refuge and my fortress, my God, in whom I trust. Surely He will save you from the fowler's snail and from the deadly pestilence. He will cover you with His feathers, and under His wings you will find refuge. His faithfulness will be your shield and rampart. You will not fear the terror of night, nor the arrow that flies by day, nor the pestilence that stalks in the darkness, nor the plague that destroys at midday. 1,000 may fall at your side, 10,000 at your right hand, but it will not come near you. You will only observe with your eyes and see the punishment of the wicked. If you say, the Lord is my refuge, and you make the Most High your dwelling, no harm will overtake you, nor disaster will come near your tent. He will command His angels concerning you to guard you in all your ways. The word of God. Amen.
As I leave you today, I ask you to pray for us as I pray for you. Pray for the leaders of the territory. Pray for the legislature, the delegate, and pray for all the leaders in our community that are directors, managers, supervisors. Pray for the healthcare workers that have to come out and brave against this horrible pandemic. Pray for the police officers, the EMTs, the first responders, the people that are delivering our packages, the people that are packing the grocery stores with shelves with food, all the people that are making it happen and coming out here and risking not only their safety, but the safety of their families to make sure that we make it one more day. God bless you and God bless the Virgin Islands.
I'm really humbled to be here today. Thank you so much, Governor, for allowing us this opportunity as a people to come before God in this season of immense difficulty and trials. You know, today, before I even begin to pray, I want to invite you to turn with me, if you're at home, in the book of 2 Chronicles chapter 7. I just want to read two quick scriptures for us this morning. These are the words directly from God. 2 Chronicles chapter 7 and verse number 13 declares, hallelujah, when I shut up the heavens so that there be no rain and command locusts to devour the land or send a plague among my people, if my people who are called by my name shall humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, then will I hear from heaven and forgive their sins and heal their land. Would you bow with me at this time as we look to God for our help? Heavenly Father, in the name of Jesus, I come before you, God. We come before you today, dear God, not to demand anything of you, O God, but just to ask, O God. Father, we are humble. This plague, O God, this situation, this virus, O God, has brought us to our knees today, dear God. And Lord, in our own strength, we are nothing, O God. In our own strength, O God, we can do nothing. So, Father, we understand today that we need you now more than ever before, dear God. Lord, all over the world, people are hurting. People are dying, oh God. People are in desperate need. But your word declares, God, if my people who are called by my name, dear God, will humble themselves. And right now, God, we humble ourselves before you. Because you are God, and unlike you, other than you, dear God, there's no other God. And Father, we bow in your presence. We say to you, dear God, to have mercy upon us, dear God. Lord, we don't deserve it, oh God, because it's a nation. We have turned our back from you, O God. As a nation, O God, we have gone after our own selfish desires, O God, our own selfish lust. But today, O God, this very day, in the name of Jesus, O God, we repent of our sins, dear God. And we ask your mercy. We ask your forgiveness. We ask your healing. We ask your cleansing on this land. God, I thank you so much for our governor, O God, who saw fit to call all these people together, O God, to basically storm the throne room of heaven. Oh God, I pray that you will bless him. I pray that you will strengthen him. I pray that you will uphold him with your right hand, oh God. Bless his wife, oh First Lady, oh God. Cover her. Cover them, oh God. Our Lieutenant Governor, oh God. Strengthen him where he stands. God, so many are going over and beyond to see this happen, oh God. To see people, oh God, be tested. To see people be treated, oh God. Father, in the name of Jesus, I'm even asking you right now to bless every member of the healthcare department, oh God, that labor day and night, oh God, that toil to be there for our people. The members, oh God, of the legislative branch, oh God, strengthen them, oh God. Every
member of cabinet, oh God. I bring them before you, God, because this is some trying times, oh God. This is some difficult times, oh God. Lord, the judicial branch, oh God, we ask that you will cover them, oh God. And every single citizen, every single person living in this Virgin Islands, oh God, especially, God, I remember the elderly that are in fear right now. Oh God, cover our elderly people. Strengthen them, dear God. I even ask right now, God, that you will encourage their hearts. Help them to look to you, God, the author and the finisher of our faith. And I pray, oh God, that anybody who does not know you as a personal Lord and Savior, that today, oh God, they will come to you and turn their hearts wholeheartedly to you. We give you all the praise. We give you all the glory. And we thank you that very soon, oh God, we will see healing. That very soon, dear God, we will see deliverance. And very soon, oh God, Lord, there will be a vaccine for this virus. And we'll be able to look back and say, look what God has done. We thank you. And I ask all these things in Jesus' name. Amen.
Virgin Islanders, let us pray. Lord God, the merciful and compassionate Father of us all, our peace and our strength, today we pray for our territory as we face this pandemic, our nation and the world. God, our healer, show your compassion for the whole human family. Come to our aid with your strong arm and your healing presence. Heal those who are sick. Support and protect their families and friends from being infected. Be present to all who mourn their dead. Give them courage and strength and faith to meet the days ahead. Comfort those around the world who cannot bury their dead. Bless physicians, nurses, and all others who minister to the sick and suffering. Keep them safe and healthy, and grant them wisdom and skill, sympathy and patience. Inspire and give insight and hope to all researchers focused on developing a vaccine and other life-saving medications and devices. Give wisdom, creativity, and perseverance to all researchers, policymakers, and leaders as they respond to this pandemic. Send down upon our President, Congress, and political leaders here in the Virgin Islands and everywhere the spirit of wisdom and charity and justice, that they may faithfully promote the well-being of all people. Guide them in finding and developing the resources and the political will to contain and finally end this pandemic. Guide leaders to speak the truth, halt the spread of misinformation, and act with justice. We pray for those who are quarantined or stranded away from home, for those who've lost employment, for those filled with fear, for those who don't know how to pay the rent, buy food, medications, and deal with double WAPA bills. We pray for children who cannot go to school and for parents who need child care. For those who seek care in overwhelmed hospitals and clinics. For the physicians, nurses, and healthcare workers in those facilities. For care workers at the limits of their power to help. Healing God, come to all in need. Unbind those held by anxiety, despair, or pain. House this mentally ill and homeless in safe places. Show us how to provide assistance for those who suffer, if in no other way than with our prayers. Heal our world, heal our bodies, strengthen our hearts and our minds, and amid the turmoil, give us hope and peace. hold us in your gentle embrace. Hold especially all those who have died and who will die this day. Comfort their loved ones in their despair. O Lord God, as we turn to you for help, look upon us with compassion and hear the fervent prayers of your people. For we pray in the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Assalamu alaikum. Peace and blessing of our Creator upon all of you. On my name and the name of the Muslims community in this island, we want to thank the governor and all the people that they make this gathering happen. And we want to congratulate our governor and those who come with this idea to join us together in a spiritual meeting that brings all our feeling together for the goodness of our island and the entire globe. First of all, my message is, we are gathering here to ask our Creator to make it, to release this situation from us as a human being. And the Creator will never release a situation from us, or will never change a situation around us, unless we change ourselves. So we need to start with ourselves. We come here to pray. And prayer is not something that we use as a tool or an instrument when we are facing calamities in our life. And when we have difficulties, we just flee to our Creator. This should be a habit that we should have in daily basis. I will start my prayer with the first part of the Holy Quran, which is the first chapter in the Quran. I will read it in Arabic, then I will translate it in English. A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين. In the name of Allah, the Creator, the Merciful, the Most Merciful, all praises are due to our Creator. Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim, the Merciful, the Most Merciful. Maliki Yawm Al-Din, the Owner of the Day of Judgment. Iyaka Na'budu Wa Iyaka Nasta'in, you only we worship, and from you only we seek help. Ihdina as-sirat al-mustaqim, guide us to the straight path. Sirat al-ladina an'amta alayhim ghayril maghdubi alayhim waladdallin. Guide us to the straight path, the path of those who you bestowed, not the path of those who gain your anger, nor the path of those who go astray. We pray to our Creator to relieve this situation from our island and from the entire globe. Amen.
Yes, greetings, peace and love to all the citizens of the Virgin Islands, to our brothers and sisters in the Caribbean, them on the mainland, South America, Asia, Europe, Africa. Send a perfect love, peace, unity unto all of us in the global family of humanity. From the theocracy reign of the ancient divine order of the Nyabingi, we send out our prayers to the Father, to the Mother of creation for healing and His mercy. Abakidus, Samen Fiskidus, Tikkuramlak. Give thanks and praises. Abatachinoi Besima Yemet Nor Semiakudes Mengustimta. Fakadi Besima in the Honech in the Hubemedetun. Yelitin jada sitin zari, better la chininim ya kid billion in yan, ya bidu lemon in ya kid in diminil. With a fitet nam atagban, kikafikulu adin in enji, mangus yantin atina, hailim, miskenam lezele clemo. Our Father who dwells in Mount Zion, blessed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in Mount Zion. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those that trespass against us. Allow us not to go into temptation, but deliver us from all evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory belongs unto the Most High, from that time to this time, and forevermore. Yes, prince and princesses, we must come out of Babylon. Ethiopians, we shall stretch forth our hands unto our divine majesty, Emperor Haile Selassie I and Empress Menin Asfa of Ethiopia. Thy spirit tread within I and I to dwell in the paths of righteousness. For thy name's sake, lead I and I. Help I and I to forgive that I and I may be forgiven. Teach I and I love, loyalty, and earth as it is in Mount Zion. Endow within I and I wise mind, knowledge, and understanding to do thy will. Thy blessings to I and I, that the hungry be fed, the naked clothed, the sick nourished, the aged protected, and the infants cared for. Deliver I and I from the hands of I and I enemies, that we may prove fruitful even in these perilous days. As I and I enemies are past and decayed, in the depths of the seas, in the depths of the earth, even in the belly of the beast. Grant unto I and I all a place within the ever-living kingdom, through the powers of the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords, the conquering Lion of the tribe of Judah, the elect of the Almighty, as the light of this world. And I, Divine Majesty, Emperor Haile Selassie I, the first King of Iration, the Alpha, Empress Menin, the Omega, the beginning without end, first and forever, protector of I and I life, I and I faith, and the ruler of this universe. So we hail unto the Most High, hail I, Selassie I, the first. O great and thunderable I, hail I, Selassie I, the first. Holy omnipotent I, hail I, Selassie I, the first. Yes, O Heavenly Father and Mother of creation, have mercy upon us. Forgive humanity of their transgression that they have committed against you. Yes, restore perfect love, restore balance in creation and in humanity, that we may show perfect love one to another. We may be our brother's keeper, our sister's keeper. We may be one family, the human family which we all belong to, regardless of color, race, creed, or denomination. For there is one Father and one Mother of creation. So we ask thee, I humbly, please have mercy upon us and forgive humanity of their transgression. Let the words of I and I mouth, the meditations of I and I heart, let the humbly be acceptable in thy sight, O Emperor Haile Selassie I and Empress Menin Asfa. For they are good towards man, humanity, and thy love shall I store us. Peace and love. Selah.
God bless everybody. Thank you for the opportunity, Governor, to be part of this event. I'm representing the Spanish community. Dios bendiga de manera especial todo el que nos escucha a través de estas redes sociales. Es una bendición para nosotros poder estar aquí presente declarando una palabra de vida, una palabra de esperanza, una palabra de fe para todo aquel que nos escucha en esta hora. Dice el Salmo 9 en el verso 9: será el eterno fortaleza del oprimido, fortaleza para los momentos de sufrimiento. Confían en Él todos los que conocen su nombre, porque tú no has abandonado a los que te buscan. Hay tres cosas esenciales en la palabra del Señor a través de este salmo. Número uno, Él es refugio. Número dos, Él es fortaleza. Y número tres, Él es nuestra confianza. Solamente a través de Jesús tenemos salvación y vida eterna. Él es nuestro Señor y Salvador. Reconocemos la presencia de Él para poder llegar a la presencia del Padre. Y en esta preciosa tarde vamos a hacer una oración para que el Eterno pueda guiarnos a través de esta situación difícil que todas las naciones estamos experimentando. Padre, te damos gracias, Señor, en esta tarde. En el nombre de Jesús venimos a tu presencia, Dios Padre, porque sabemos, Señor, que tú habitas en luz inaccesible, habitas en tu trono. Pero aunque estás sentado, Señor, tienes control de todo lo que surge a través de la naturaleza, Padre. Tú no estás en cuarentena, Señor. Tú estás en medio de todo el proceso que estamos experimentando. Por eso en esta tarde te pedimos que tu presencia, Señor, pueda llegar aún a nuestro gobierno, Señor, para darle sabiduría en momentos donde tendrá que tomar decisiones fuertes. Te pedimos, Señor, también por todo ese equipo de trabajo que está al frente de la guerra, los enfermeros, los doctores, todos los que componen el equipo que está trabajando fuertemente para enfrentar esta situación. También te presentamos, Señor, a cada una de las personas que están siendo afectadas en estos momentos. Personas, Señor, en momentos de desesperación, de ansiedad, donde sus emociones quizás están siendo afectadas, Padre, porque muchos de ellos tendrán que enfrentar la muerte. Yo te pido, Señor, que como tú estuviste con tu hijo, tú seas sustento a todo aquel que en este momento tiene esa necesidad. Sé refugio, sé fortaleza, Señor. Sé confianza para aquellos que nos escuchan en esta hora y que quizás están desesperados, están angustiados, están temerosos, están llenos de miedo, Señor. Yo te pido, Señor, que tú, a través de tu Hijo Jesús, puedas llegarte a cada hogar, a cada lugar, a cada vida, Señor, para que puedas llegar ahí y dar la paz que todos necesitamos. Tú dices en tu palabra que tú nos das tu paz, una paz que el mundo no puede dar, porque no proviene del mundo, proviene de tú, proviene de ti, que experimentaste todo lo que nosotros experimentamos. Por eso te pedimos en esta hora, Señor, que seas tú cubriendo, Dios, a todo aquel que está en necesidad en esta hora, Señor. Te pedimos, Señor, que tú seas obrando de manera especial, Padre, aún donde nosotros no podemos llegar, por medio, Señor, de la palabra, por medio de un mensaje, por medio, Señor, de lo que podamos experimentar. Te doy gracias en esta hora, Señor, y te pido por nuestra isla y las vírgenes, Santa Cruz, San Tomás y Sañón, que tú bendigas nuestras islas y que bendigas nuestra nación. En el nombre de Jesús oramos. Amén y amén.
Let us pray. God Almighty, we humble ourselves in your presence even now. We acknowledge, God, that you are the great I am. We acknowledge that you are sovereign of this universe. We acknowledge that you are omnipotent, omnipresent, and omniscient. We acknowledge that, God, you are God all by yourself, and hallelujah, there is absolutely none like you. You are the Lord and Master of all that you survey. You are Jehovah Jireh, Jehovah Nissi, Jehovah Sitkenu, Jehovah Shammah, Jehovah Shalom. Light of the world, you step down into our darkness. God, open our eyes that we may see you clearly. Open our ears that we may hear and obey. God, in spite of ourselves, you love us with an everlasting love. And you have called us to love each other as you have loved us. Oh, how we have failed you, God. We have dishonored you in our thoughts and our words and our deeds. In this Lenten season, you are calling us to repentance. We recognize that your wrath has been kindled against us, and you have called your entire universe to attention. You have turned this world upside down, yet we are defiant. Father, forgive us. We acknowledge that you have the whole world in your hands, and that you've been speaking to us long before COVID-19, 9/11, wars and rumors of wars, mudslides and earthquakes in diverse places, destructive fires, devastating hurricanes. Yet our ears are filled with wax so we cannot hear. Father, forgive us. You have called us to a global quarantine, giving us time to acknowledge the folly of our ways and to recognize that, oh God, you are still on the throne. Yet we defy the order to exercise social distancing and refuse to stay at home for our own safety and for the safety of those you have called us to love. You have given us guidelines through the governor, CDC, and our health authorities, and some are not taking these seriously. God, forgive us. We thank you for the leadership of Governor Bryan and his cabinet, members of the legislature, and those on the front lines. God, bless them and strengthen them for the days ahead. Help us to recognize your voice, Father, in this pandemic. Almighty God, I pray even now that everyone who hears my voice may be convicted by the power of your Holy Spirit, that they may come to know you, Lord, whom to know is life eternal. Take our thoughts, our deeds, and our words captive unto the obedience of Jesus Christ, Son of the living God, and use us to declare your truth, your glory, and your faithfulness. As a result of Corona, Father, people are hurting. People are scared. People are sick. People are dying, and people are mourning. Father God, have mercy. Nations are under lockdown and some under curfew. Father, help us in this time of chaos. God, I declare today that you are our strength. You are our hope. Your promise, you promise, oh God, never to leave us or forsake us. And God, we claim that promise in the name of Jesus. 2 Timothy 1:7 declares that you have not given us a spirit of fear, but of power, of love, and of a sound mind. Help us, Lord, to exercise our faith in you and trust you, because we know that you are the same yesterday, today, and forever. And your promises are yea and amen. Father, in the midst of this turmoil and chaos, you are our peace, the peace that passes all understanding. God, help us to trust you to see us through. I plead the blood of Jesus on each of us, our families, the United States and British Virgin Islands, the Caribbean Islands, all 50 states, every nation, every continent, the four corners of this earth. The blood of Jesus will never lose its power. Thank you, Father, for that it reaches to the highest mountain and it flows to the lowest valley. And the blood that gives us strength from day to day will never lose its power. We plead your blood, Father, over this COVID-19 pandemic and trust you for deliverance. In Jesus' name, we surrender all to your will and to your way. God, grant us endurance and strengthen our faith so that we may stand in steadfast obedience. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. Jehovah has the final say.
so delighted this morning that we can, on behalf of the Seventh-day Adventist Church, join with the nation in seeking the face of the Lord at such a crucial and critical time in Earth's history. In a time when men's hearts are failing them for fear, we are so happy that we have an anchor that keeps the soul. And so this morning, we just want to join in concert in prayer to our mighty God so that He may heal our land. Let us pray. Almighty God, what an awesome God you are. There's none like you in the heaven and the earth. Heaven is thy home, but the earth is thy footstool. You are merciful, compassionate. You are God who is awesome, but yet you are accessible and available because you are God who are touched with the feelings of our infirmity. We come because our needs are many. We come because we are so puny, but you are so powerful. In the light of this virus that stalks our land, we realize that we are both hopeless and helpless. But we are so happy that in times like these, we have a God who is a mighty bulwark. He never fails, and we can call upon Him, and we are confident that He will answer. He said in His word, if my people, which are called by my name, in the time of pestilence shall seek my face, that He will not only hear, but He will answer and He will heal our land. And so this morning, Lord, we come before you. Nothing in our hands we bring. We cling to you who are God Almighty. We want to pray in a special way that you may manifest your presence and manifest your power in this nation. We seek your face because the virus brings death and fear and hopelessness. We look at us and as a people, we are devastated. We are depressed. We are cast down. Oh Lord, we call upon you because hope is displaced. Hope is misplaced. Hope is replaced. And for many, life seems to be a hopeless end, but we're so happy with Jesus, we have an endless hope. And so we come to you this morning, realizing that you are a mighty fortress, is our God, a bulwark never failing. Yes, we amidst the flood of mortal ills prevailing, that there's one answer, and that answer is sure, and it is on the rock, Christ Jesus. And so this morning, we pray for our nation. We pray for our leaders, Lord, the men and women whom you have placed in authority, the governor and his entire leadership staff. Oh God, grant them the uncanny wisdom, that wisdom that they may seek your face and you may endow them with the right solutions, the best pathways, the best decisions. So as they adjudicate and make decisions in this critical time of challenge and crisis, there may be decisions that may lead to the health of our nation. Oh Lord, we pray for the many at the frontiers fighting this vicious battle. We pray for the doctors and the nurses and the first responders, those men and women who are sacrificially giving of their time and services and even giving the ultimate sacrifice of their lives because they love the service and they love the people. Oh Lord, the stench of death rises, and we hear the wail and the cries of pain and sickness and suffering. Oh God, you are a great mediator. You are a healer. And so come by here now and visit us. Walk among us and heal, restore. Give us hope. Give us the confidence that we can trust in our God. He's our refuge. You promised us that there will come a time when the immovable will move, but we are so confident that in Christ we have an answer. Bless us as a nation and as a people, and grant us an answer. Heal our land. In Jesus' name we ask it. Amen.
For us to pray and to understand that this is a time for us not to play. President George Washington said on the 17th day of October, 1789, he said that it is the duty of all nations that we must acknowledge the providence of God, to take note of his benefits that he has loaded with us daily, and to implore him in a time of need for favor and protection. This is indeed a time that governors have called for times of prayer and fasting and reflection. And we thank God today for our governor making this declaration and proclamation that today is a day that we ought to pray, fast, and reflect. I want to permit me just a few moments, if you can. If you go look in your words in your Bible, look at the scripture, Philippians chapter 4, verse 6. And there is where I want us to begin before we begin to pray. Philippians 4, chapter verse 6. And it states, be anxious for nothing, but in everything, by prayer and supplication, with thanksgiving, let your requests be made known unto God. Let's pray. God, indeed, right now we call on you, the God of mercy and the God of grace, that you allow mercy to triumph over judgment. We come right now knowing that we dwell under your shadow. We abide where you dwell. We come right now acknowledging, God, that we need you in this territory. We need you in this world. We need you in these your nations. We thank you right now, God, for who you are, that you are able. You are able to do exceedingly, abundantly, above all that we can ask or even imagine. So God, right now we use the words that you've given us, spirit and life, to prophesy over dead bones. We speak even now to things that seems to be bland and without your spirit. And God, we enliven it with your word and with your truth. We come right now, God, declaring over this territory that you are the same God yesterday, today, and forevermore. We thank you that you are aware of what's happening every single moment. And God, right now we call those things that be not, and we take this moment to give attention to you. You've called your people to humble themselves, to pray and to seek your face, and to turn from their wicked ways. And God, here we are today on bended knees. Here we are today with bowed hearts. Here we are today, God, to say, have your way. God, we're praying a covering even now over the minds and the heads of your leaders, that your leaders will begin to walk in the light and that they will lead justly. God, we take not this moment to say we checked off a box, but God, we come to call on your name. We are here proclaiming that Jesus is King, that Jesus is Lord, that Jesus is Healer, that Jesus is Sustainer. And God, we thank you for what you are doing. We let our request be made known
out unto you, because you say, if we ask anything in your name, according to your will, that will you do. So God, right now we speak blessings over this land, that there's no virus, no plague that shall come nigh our dwelling. We are established in righteousness, so oppression is far from us. We declare today, if we be your children, you will cover us, you will keep us, you will make sure that you direct our paths. So God, we thank you today for what the governor has stated, that the health care providers, the caregivers, that they're covered and protected by you. We do not deserve it, but God, you saw fit to give us another opportunity to come into your presence and to pull on your virtue of healing. So heal us once again. Create in us a clean heart and renew a right spirit within us. So God, we say, oh, you are able. You are able. You are able. Yes, you are. You're so able, God. And we thank you for who you are and what you have been doing. If we can sing it as a territory. Oh. Come on, declare it out of your mouth. He's able. Come on, come on, let's sing it.
Your name, we decree and we declare that there's none like you. Father God, you tell us in your word we are to give you back your word. Father God, I give you your word from the book of 2 Chronicles, and I begin at verse 13. You tell us, God, if you shut up heaven that there be no rain, or if you command the locusts to deliver the land, or if you send pestilence among your people, you said, if your people, which are called by your name, shall humble themselves and pray and seek your face and turn from our wicked ways, then you said, Lord, you will hear from heaven and will forgive our sins and heal our land. Father God, you gave us opportunity to choose right from wrong by telling us if. So Father, I thank you for our governor. I thank you for his cabinet members. I thank you for president, because you said we are to pray for those that have the rule over us. Father God, I pray for the spiritual leaders, not only in the Virgin Islands, but around the world. And I'm thanking you in advance, God, that you're not only hearing, but I believe by faith that you have already sent the answer. In your word, when Daniel prayed, immediately the answer came, but it was held back by the wicked portion. Father God, many have prayed prior to me. And I come to you now as Daddy God, on behalf of the entire Virgin Islands, the Caribbean Islands, and the entire world. And first of all, Daddy God, we ask you to forgive us. We have done wrong. We acknowledge our faults. And you promise, if we will continue to do what you tell us to do, you will hear our prayer. Father and God, this virus, this disease, call it what we may, we know, Father God, that the answer, the healing is already there. So now we ask that you will dispatch your warring angels to go to wherever, whether in the Virgin Islands or where, and just like Jesus, your son, did, snatch the key, snatch Kutama, snatch from the enemy the medication, the wisdom, the whatever that is needed, God, to take this virus away from the world. Because it's not only one area, it's the entire earth that is suffering. Father and eternal God, I stand here, God, and holy on my knees, God, I stand as the attorney on behalf of those that would see or hear what your Holy Spirit is speaking through me. And I plead my case to you, Daddy God. I've come to you many times before, and you answered. You heard and you answered. And here I am again, God, pleading the case for the Virgin Islands, for your people, oh God, concerning the pain and the suffering, the fear, God, that your people are fearing. But I give you your word back. You promise us that fear is not of you. You promise us, Daddy God, that if we pray, you would answer, you would hear, and you would answer. So, Father God, go to every home, every hospital, every institution. And I'm asking you by faith, believing that the cure is already there. Open up the eyes of the doctors and the scientists and the other big names that I can't call. But you know them, Daddy God. And I'm not going to give you any date. But God, I'm believing that soon and very soon, we will begin to see the change. You are God. There's none like you. You have made us all. And you said, Daddy God, that you don't wish for any to suffer. Daddy God, you see the suffering. Even the babies, oh God, are suffering. The elders like myself are suffering. Elders. God, you said that you are jealous concerning the widows. In your word, you said, suffer the little children to come unto me and forbid them not. For such is the kingdom of God. So, Father God, I thank you that when Moses, your man, that you sent to Pharaoh and you told Pharaoh, let my people go. And Pharaoh said, go, then he changed his mind. But he was touched when his son got touched. I speak to that coronavirus now in the name of Jesus the Christ. I take authority for you, because my God told me he has given me power and authority, his power and his authority. And I take it now and I wield it against that virus. And I speak to you in the name of Jesus. And I go to the root cause. And I command you to dry up. I command you to leave this earth. This earth is not yours, devil. The blood of Jesus Christ of Nazareth is against you. My God, he tells you he's given us power and authority. So I have the authority to tell you where to go. Go back from whence you came in the name of Jesus. And set the people of God free. I know there are many that are scared. I know that there are many that are sad. I have lost loved ones. And I know what it is to lose a loved one. But I want to say today to all that's listening to my voice, just a few lines of a wonderful song that you all know. What a friend we have in Jesus. All our sins and griefs to bear. What a privilege to carry everything. Everything, including coronavirus, to God in prayer. I pray for our governor again. I pray for his cabinet. I pray for the people of these Virgin Islands. I pray for these people around the world. And I encourage you, God is not only able, he's also willing. And by faith, I am believing that soon, and very soon, we're going to hear it. They're going to say that they have found the cure, but we know that God is the one, and God alone is the one to give us the cure. Don't give up. Don't give in. Keep on praying in Jesus' name. Amen.
The hottest after party in the Virgin Islands. To get in, all you need is car keys and a drink.
Had any alcoholic beverages tonight?
Yeah, I just had one drink.
Isn't this one after party you can skip? This message from the VI Office of Highway Safety through funds provided by the National Highway Traffic Safety Administration.
There's no way to hide it. If you drive drunk, we will find you. Cops everywhere are stepping up enforcement and cracking down like never before.
Sir, have you been drinking tonight? Sir, have you been drinking this evening?
Sir, have you been drinking tonight?
Make no mistake, you will get caught and you will be arrested. Over the limit, under arrest.
Hey Ray, how's it going?
Great, so you pulled me over.
You forgot to use your turn signal back there.
Yeah, sorry about that.
I'll give you a warning, just watch it next time.
Yeah, I will. Hey, you still going to the game on Friday?
You betcha.
What are you writing?
A ticket. For what? For not wearing your safety belt.
You're kidding me.
Afraid not. See you Friday.
We're stepping up safety belt enforcement. If you don't buckle up, you will get a ticket. No exceptions. Click it or ticket.
Can I have 2 fried chicken legs, 4 Johnny cake, and a rum and coke? Or and 2 slices of chocolate cake, 1 for now and 1 for later.
Nadia, you really gonna eat all of that? You need to make better food choices. Heart disease runs in our family. Grandma got high blood pressure, and Uncle Billy just had a stroke.
Well, I young and I don't exercise 2 days a week.
That is not enough.
Managing heart disease might be difficult, but with better choices and healthier living, we can get through it. Avoid overeating. A balanced diet in the right proportions can reduce the risk of heart disease. Exercise at least 30 minutes per day, 3 times a week. Make it a lifestyle. Virgin Islands Vital Statistics data shows that heart disease is one of the leading causes of death in the territory. For more ways you can reduce the risk of heart disease, visit the DOH office today.
Good morning. Thank you, each and every one of you, for joining us today in a time of fasting, reflection, and most of all, prayer. This is a troubling time in our world, and indeed a troubling time in our territory. But in all the troubles we have seen together, we have always known that there is a great Father above that guides our every move. And every single day we ask Him for guidance in getting through the simple things. And now we have a great task before us, the task of getting our people through this most horrific worldwide pandemic. But we trust and we have faith that He is with us and He walks with us. And this is a time that He has set aside for us to look at what we're doing, look at the lives we're leading, look at our neighbor, our community, our children, and find time to reflect on how we can do and what we can do to make life a little better. And as we sit today and think about the goodness of the Virgin Islands and the Lord and all that He has provided for us, it is also a time to be thankful and grateful for all that we do have to combat this pandemic. Through all the things that we have been through, the one thing that we have been able to count on is each other. And we too must reflect on the bonds that hold this community together, that keep us tight, that gives us the love and the strength of a community, that helps us to raise our children, to get along day by day, to relish in our diversity, and to overcome all of the tribulations and the trials that come before us. Today is but one day of a long, arduous road we have as we make it through this worldwide pandemic. But I trust that the God above gives me, you, and the entire Virgin Islands, the wisdom, the perseverance, and the get-go to get up every single day and do the things that are needed to get our community through this. I really like to thank everyone and our staff and in the community that made today a success, and all of the pastors of different faith that have shown up here today to add a little bit of love, light, and mostly hope to a very dark situation. We, over the weekend, we went over several Psalms, and the wife and I, Yolanda, decided on one that would be fitting for this appropriate and comforting for all ages. So I asked her to join me now as she says this, recites this psalm for you, Yolanda.
Thank you, Governor. And to that I say, amen. Greetings, Virgin Islands. Today I will be reading from the book of Psalms, chapters 91, verse 1 through 11. And it reads, whoever dwells in the shelter of the Most High will rest in the shadow of the Almighty. I will say of the Lord, He is my refuge and my fortress, my God, in whom I trust. Surely He will save you from the fowler's snail and from the deadly pestilence. He will cover you with His feathers, and under His wings you will find refuge. His faithfulness will be your shield and rampart. You will not fear the terror of night, nor the arrow that flies by day, nor the pestilence that stalks in the darkness, nor the plague that destroys at midday. 1,000 may fall at your side, 10,000 at your right hand, but it will not come near you. You will only observe with your eyes and see the punishment of the wicked. If you say, the Lord is my refuge, and you make the Most High your dwelling, no harm will overtake you, nor disaster will come near your tent. He will command His angels concerning you to guard you in all your ways. The word of God. Amen.
As I leave you today, I ask you to pray for us as I pray for you. Pray for the leaders of the territory. Pray for the legislature, the delegate. And pray for all the leaders in our community that are directors, managers, supervisors. Pray for the healthcare workers that have to come out and brave against this horrible pandemic. Pray for the police officers, the EMTs, the first responders, the people that are delivering our packages, the people that are packing the grocery stores with shelves with food, all the people that are making it happen and coming out here and risking not only their safety, but the safety of their families, to make sure that we make it one more day. God bless you, and God bless the Virgin Islands.
Good day, everyone. I'm really humbled to be here today. Thank you so much, Governor, for allowing us this opportunity as a people to come before God in this season of immense difficulty and trials. You know, today, before I even begin to pray, I want to invite you to turn with me, if you're at home, in the book of 2 Chronicles chapter 7. I just want to read two quick scriptures for us this morning. These are the words directly from God. 2 Chronicles chapter 7 and verse number 13 declares, hallelujah, when I shut up the heavens so that there be no rain, and command locusts to devour the land, or send a plague among my people, if my people who are called by my name shall humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, then will I hear from heaven and forgive their sins and heal their land. Would you bow with me at this time as we look to God for our help? Heavenly Father, in the name of Jesus, I come before you, God. We come before you today, dear God, not to demand anything of you, oh God, but just to ask, oh God. Father, we are humble. This plague, oh God, this situation, this virus, oh God, has brought us to our knees today, dear God. And Lord, in our own strength, we are nothing, oh God. In our own strength, oh God, we can do nothing. So Father, we understand today that we need you now more than ever before, dear God. Lord, all over the world, people are hurting, people are dying, oh God, people are in desperate need, but your word declares, God, if my people who are called by my name, dear God, will humble themselves, and right now, God, we humble ourselves before you, because you are God, and unlike you, other than you, dear God, is no other God. And Father, we bow in your presence. We say to you, dear God, to have mercy upon us, dear God. Lord, we don't deserve it, oh God, because it's a nation. We have turned our back from you, oh God. As our nation, oh God, we have gone after our own selfish desires, oh God, our own selfish lust. But today, oh God, this very day, in the name of Jesus, oh God, we repent of our sins, dear God, and we ask your mercy, we ask your forgiveness, we ask your healing, we ask your cleansing on this land. God, I thank you so much for our governor, oh God, who saw fit to call all these people together, oh God, to basically storm the throne room of heaven. Oh God, I pray that you will bless him. I pray that you will strengthen him. I pray that you will uphold him with your right hand, oh God. Bless his wife, oh First Lady, oh God. Cover her. Cover them, oh God. Our Lieutenant Governor, oh God. Strengthen him where he stands. God, so many are going over and beyond to see this happen, oh God. To see people, oh God, be tested. To see people be treated, oh God. Father, in the name of Jesus, I'm even asking you right now to bless every member of the healthcare department, oh God, that labor day and night, oh God, that toil to be there for our people. The members, oh God, of the legislative branch, oh God, strengthen them, oh God. Every member of cabinet, oh God, I bring them before you, oh God, because this is some trying times, oh God. This is some difficult times, oh God. Lord, the judicial branch, oh God, we ask that you will cover them, oh God, and every single citizen, every single person living in this Virgin Islands, oh God, especially, God, I remember the elderly that are in fear right now. Oh God, cover our elderly people, strengthen them, dear God. I even ask right now, God, that you will encourage their hearts, help them to look to you, God, the author and the finisher of our faith. And I pray, oh God, that anybody who does not know you as a personal Lord and Savior, that today, oh God, they will come to you and turn their hearts wholeheartedly to you. We give you all the praise, we give you all the glory, and we thank you that very soon, oh God, we will see healing. That very soon, dear God, we will see deliverance. And very soon, oh God, Lord, there will be a vaccine for this virus. And we will be able to look back and say, look what God has done. We thank you. And I ask all these things in Jesus' name. Amen.
my fellow Virgin Islanders, let us pray. Lord God, the merciful and compassionate Father of us all, our peace and our strength, today we pray for our territory as we face this pandemic, our nation and the world. God, our healer, show your compassion for the whole human family. Come to our aid with your strong arm and your healing presence. Heal those who are sick. Support and protect their families and friends from being infected. Be present to all who mourn their dead. Give them courage and strength and faith to meet the days ahead. Comfort those around the world who cannot bury their dead. Bless physicians, nurses, and all others who minister to the sick and suffering. Keep them safe and healthy, and grant them wisdom and skill, sympathy and patience. Inspire and give insight and hope to all researchers focused on developing a vaccine and other life-saving medications and devices. Give wisdom, creativity, and perseverance to all researchers, policymakers, and leaders as they respond to this pandemic. Send down upon our President, Congress, and political leaders here in the Virgin Islands and everywhere the spirit of wisdom and charity and justice, that they may faithfully promote the well-being of all people. Guide them in finding and developing the resources and the political will to contain and finally end this pandemic. Guide leaders to speak the truth, halt the spread of misinformation, and act with justice. We pray for those who are quarantined or stranded away from home, for those who've lost employment, for those filled with fear, for those who don't know how to pay the rent, buy food, medications, and deal with double WAPA bills. We pray for children who cannot go to school and for parents who need child care. For those who seek care in overwhelmed hospitals and clinics, for the physicians, nurses, and healthcare workers in those facilities, for care workers at the limits of their power to help. Healing God, come to all in need. Unbind those held by anxiety, despair, or pain. House this mentally ill and homeless in safe places. Show us how to provide assistance for those who suffer, if in no other way than with our prayers. Heal our world, heal our bodies, strengthen our hearts and our minds, and amid the turmoil, give us hope and peace. Hold us in your gentle embrace. Hold especially all those who have died and who will die this day. Comfort their loved ones in their despair. O Lord God, as we turn to you for help, look upon us with compassion and hear the fervent prayers of your people. For we pray in the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Assalamu alaikum. Peace and blessing of our Creator upon all of you. On my name and the name of the Muslims community in this island, we want to thank the governor and all the people that they make this gathering happen. And we want to congratulate our governor and those who come with this idea to join us together in a spiritual meeting that bring all our feeling together for the goodness of our island and the entire globe. First of all, my message is, we are gathering here to ask our Creator to make it, to release this situation from us as a human being. And the Creator will never release a situation from us, or will never change the situation around us unless we change ourselves. So we need to start with ourselves. We come here to pray. And prayer is not something that we use as a tool or an instrument when we are facing calamities in our life. And when we have difficulties, we just flee to our Creator. This should be a habit that we should have in daily basis. I will start my prayer with the first part of the Holy Quran, which is the first chapter in the Quran. I will read it in Arabic, then I will translate it in English. A'udhu billahi minash shaytanir rajim. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين. In the name of Allah, the Creator, the Merciful, the Most Merciful, all praises are due to our Creator. Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim, the Merciful, the Most Merciful. Maliki Yawm Al-Din, the Owner of the Day of Judgment. Iyaka Na'budu Wa Iyaka Nasta'in, you only we worship, and from you only we seek help. Ihdina as-sirat al-mustaqim, guide us to the straight path. Sirat al-ladina an'amta alayhim ghayril maghdubi alayhim waladdallin. Guide us to the straight path, the path of those who you bestowed, not the path of those who gain your anger, nor the path of those who go astray. We pray to our Creator to relieve this situation from our island and from the entire globe. Amen.
Yes, greetings, peace and love to all the citizens of the Virgin Islands, to our brothers and sisters in the Caribbean, them on the mainland, South America, Asia, Europe, Africa. Send a perfect love, peace, unity unto all of us in the global family of humanity. From the theocracy reign of the ancient divine art of the Nyabingi, we send out our prayers to the Father, to the Mother of Creation for healing and His mercy. Abakidus, Samen Fiskidus, Tikurdamlak. Give thanks and praises. Abatachinoi Besima Yemetnor Semiakudes Mengustimta. Fakade besima in the honech in the hubemedel tune. Yelletin jada sitting zari, better la chinin in your kid billion in yan, yabu lemon in your kid in diminil. With a fetet nam attack ban, kikafikulu adin in engi, mangus yantin atina, haile, miss kenam lezele clemo. Our Father who dwells in Mount Zion, blessed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in Mount Zion. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those that trespass against us. Allow us not to go into temptation, but deliver us from all evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory belongs unto the Most High from that time to this time and forevermore. Yes, prince and princesses, we must come out of Babylon. Ethiopians, we shall stretch forth our hands unto our divine majesty, Emperor Haile Selassie I and Empress Menin Asfa of Ethiopia. Thy spirit tread within I and I to dwell in the paths of righteousness. For thy name's sake, lead I and I. Help I and I to forgive that I and I may be forgiven. Teach I and I love, loyalty, and earth as it is in Mount Zion. Endow within I and I wise mind, knowledge, and understanding to do thy will. Thy blessings to I and I, that the hungry be fed, the naked clothed, the sick nourished, the aged protected, and the infants cared for. Deliver I and I from the hands of I and I enemies, that we may prove fruitful even in these perilous days. As I and I enemies are past and decayed, in the depths of the seas, in the depths of the earth, even in the belly of the beast. Grant unto I and I all a place within the ever-living kingdom, through the powers of the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords, the conquering Lion of the tribe of Judah, the elect of the Almighty, as the light of this world. And I, divine majesty, Emperor Haile Selassie I, the first king of Iration, the Alpha, Empress Menin, the Omega, the beginning without end, first and forever, protector of I and I life, I and I faith, and the ruler of this universe. So we hail unto the Most High, hail I, Selassie I, the first. O great and thunderable I, hail I, Selassie I, the first. Holy omnipotent I, hail I, Selassie I, the first. Yes, O Heavenly Father and Mother of creation, have mercy upon us. Forgive humanity of their transgression that they have committed against you. Yes, restore perfect love, restore balance in creation and in humanity, that we may show perfect love one to another. We may be our brother's keeper, our sister's keeper. We may be one family, the human family which we all belong to, regardless of color, race, creed, or denomination. For there is one Father and one Mother of creation. So we ask thee, I humbly, please have mercy upon us and forgive humanity of their transgression. Let the words of I and I mouth, the meditations of I and I heart, let the humbly be acceptable in thy sight, O Emperor Haile Selassie I and Empress Menin Asfa. For thee I are good towards man, humanity, and thy love shall I store us. Peace and love. Selah.
God bless everybody. Thank you for the opportunity, Governor, to be part of this event. I'm representing the Spanish community. Dios bendiga de manera especial todo el que nos escucha a través de estas redes sociales. Es una bendición para nosotros poder estar aquí presente declarando una palabra de vida, una palabra de esperanza, una palabra de fe para todo aquel que nos escucha en esta hora. Dice el Salmo 9 en el verso 9: será el eterno fortaleza del oprimido, fortaleza para los momentos de sufrimiento. Confían en él todos los que conocen su nombre, porque tú no has abandonado a los que te buscan. Hay tres cosas esenciales en la palabra del Señor a través de este Salmo. Número uno, él es refugio. Número dos, él es fortaleza. Y número tres, él es nuestra confianza. Solamente a través de Jesús tenemos salvación y vida eterna. Él es nuestro Señor y Salvador. Reconocemos la presencia de Él para poder llegar a la presencia del Padre. Y en esta preciosa tarde vamos a hacer una oración para que el Eterno pueda guiarnos a través de esta situación difícil que todas las naciones estamos experimentando. Padre, te damos gracias, Señor, en esta tarde. En el nombre de Jesús venimos a tu presencia, Dios Padre, porque sabemos, Señor, que tú habitas en luz inaccesible, habitas en tu trono. Pero aunque estás sentado, Señor, tienes control de todo lo que surge a través de la naturaleza, Padre. Tú no estás en cuarentena, Señor. Tú estás en medio de todo el proceso que estamos experimentando. Por eso en esta tarde te pedimos que tu presencia, Señor, pueda llegar aún a nuestro gobierno, Señor, para darle sabiduría en momentos donde tendrá que tomar decisiones fuertes. Te pedimos, Señor, también por todo ese equipo de trabajo que está al frente de la guerra, los enfermeros, los doctores, todos los que componen el equipo que está trabajando fuertemente para enfrentar esta situación. También te presentamos, Señor, a cada una de las personas que están siendo afectadas en estos momentos. Personas, Señor, en momentos de desesperación, de ansiedad, donde sus emociones quizás están siendo afectadas, Padre, porque muchos de ellos tendrán que enfrentar la muerte. Yo te pido, Señor, que como tú estuviste con tu hijo, tú seas sustento a todo aquel que en este momento tiene esa necesidad. Sé refugio, sé fortaleza, Señor. Sé confianza para aquellos que nos escuchan en esta hora y que quizás están desesperados, están angustiados, están temerosos, están llenos de miedo, Señor. Yo te pido, Señor, que tú, a través de tu Hijo Jesús, puedas llegarte a cada hogar, a cada lugar, a cada vida, Señor, para que puedas llegar ahí y dar la paz que todos necesitamos. Tú dices en tu palabra que tú nos das tu paz, una paz que el mundo no puede dar, porque no proviene del mundo, proviene de tú, proviene de ti, que experimentaste todo lo que nosotros experimentamos. Por eso te pedimos en esta hora, Señor, que seas tú cubriendo, Dios, a todo aquel que está en necesidad en esta hora, Señor. Te pedimos, Señor, que tú seas obrando de manera especial, Padre, aún donde nosotros no podemos llegar, por medio, Señor, de la palabra, por medio de un mensaje, por medio, Señor, de lo que podamos experimentar. Te doy gracias en esta hora, Señor, y te pido por nuestra isla, Islas Vírgenes, Santa Cruz, San Tomás y Sañón, que tú bendigas nuestras islas y que bendigas nuestra nación. En el nombre de Jesús oramos. Amén y amén.
Let us pray. God Almighty, we humble ourselves in your presence even now. We acknowledge, God, that you are the great I am. We acknowledge that you are sovereign of this universe. We acknowledge that you are omnipotent, omnipresent, and omniscient. We acknowledge that, God, you are God all by yourself, and hallelujah, there is absolutely none like you. You are the Lord and Master of all that you survey. You are Jehovah Jireh, Jehovah Nissi, Jehovah Sitkenu, Jehovah Shammah, Jehovah Shalom. Light of the world, you step down into our darkness. God, open our eyes that we may see you clearly. Open our ears that we may hear and obey. God, in spite of ourselves, you love us with an everlasting love. And you have called us to love each other as you have loved us. Oh, how we have failed you, God. We have dishonored you in our thoughts and our words and our deeds. In this Lenten season, you are calling us to repentance. We recognize that your wrath has been kindled against us, and you have called your entire universe to attention. You have turned this world upside down, yet we are defiant. Father, forgive us. We acknowledge that you have the whole world in your hands and that you've been speaking to us long before COVID-19. 9/11, wars and rumors of wars, mudslides and earthquakes in diverse places, destructive fires, devastating hurricanes. Yet our ears are filled with wax so we cannot hear. Father, forgive us. You have called us to a global quarantine, given us time to acknowledge the folly of our ways and to recognize that, oh God, you are still on the throne. Yet we defy the order to exercise social distancing and refuse to stay at home for our own safety and for the safety of those you have called us to love. You have given us guidelines through the governor, CDC, and our health authorities, and some are not taking these seriously. God, forgive us. We thank you for the leadership of Governor Bryan and his cabinet, members of the legislature, and those on the front lines. God, bless them and strengthen them for the days ahead. Help us to recognize your voice, Father, in this pandemic. Almighty God, I pray even now that everyone who hears my voice may be convicted by the power of your Holy Spirit, that they may come to know you, Lord, whom to know is life eternal. Take our thoughts, our deeds, and our words captive unto the obedience of Jesus Christ, Son of the living God, and use us to declare your truth, your glory, and your faithfulness. As a result of Corona, Father, people are hurting. People are scared. People are sick. People are dying and people are mourning. Father God, have mercy. Nations are under lockdown and some under curfew. Father, help us in this time of chaos. God, I declare today that you are our strength. You are our hope. Your promise, you promise, oh God, never to leave us or forsake us. And God, we claim that promise in the name of Jesus. 2 Timothy 1:7 declares that you have not given us a spirit of fear, but of power, of love, and of a sound mind. Help us, Lord, to exercise our faith in you and trust you, because we know that you are the same yesterday, today, and forever. And your promises are yea and amen. Father, in the midst of this turmoil and chaos, you are our peace, the peace that passes all understanding. God, help us to trust you to see us through. I plead the blood of Jesus on each of us, our families, the United States and British Virgin Islands, the Caribbean Islands, all 50 states, every nation, every continent, the four corners of this earth. The blood of Jesus will never lose its power. Thank you, Father, for that it reaches to the highest mountain and it flows to the lowest valley. And the blood that gives us strength from day to day will never lose its power. We plead your blood, Father, over this COVID-19 pandemic and trust you for deliverance. In Jesus' name, we surrender all to your will and to your way. God, grant us endurance and strengthen our faith so that we may stand in steadfast obedience. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. Jehovah has the final say.
So delighted this morning that we can, on behalf of the Seventh-day Adventist Church, join with the nation in seeking the face of the Lord at such a crucial and critical time in Earth's history. In a time when men's hearts are failing them for fear, we are so happy that we have an anchor that keeps the soul. And so this morning, we just want to join in concert in prayer to our mighty God so that he may heal our land. Let us pray. Almighty God, what an awesome God you are. There's none like you in the heaven and the earth. Heaven is thy home, but the earth is thy footstool. You are merciful, compassionate. You are God who is awesome, but yet you are accessible and available because you are God who are touched with the feelings of our infirmity. We come because our needs are many. We come because we are so puny, but you are so powerful. In the light of this virus that stalks our land, we realize that we are both hopeless and helpless. But we are so happy that in times like these, we have a God who is a mighty bulwark. He never fails, and we can call upon him, and we are confident that he will answer. He said in his word, if my people, which are called by my name, in the time of pestilence shall seek my face, that he will not only hear, but he will answer and he will heal our land. And so this morning, Lord, we come before you. Nothing in our hands we bring. We cling to you, who are God Almighty. We want to pray in a special way that you may manifest your presence and manifest your power in this nation. We seek your face because the virus brings death and fear and hopelessness. We look at us, and as a people, we are devastated. We are depressed. We are cast down. Oh, Lord, we call upon you because hope is displaced. Hope is misplaced. Hope is replaced. And for many, life seems to be a hopeless end, but we're so happy with Jesus, we have an endless hope. And so we come to you this morning, realizing that you are a mighty fortress, is our God, a bulwark never failing. Yes, we amidst the flood of mortal ills prevailing, that there's one answer, and that answer is sure, and it is on the rock, Christ Jesus. And so this morning, we pray for our nation. We pray for our leaders, Lord, the men and women whom you have placed in authority, the governor and his entire leadership staff. Oh God, grant them the uncanny wisdom, that wisdom that they may seek your face and you may endow them with the right solutions, the best pathways, the best decisions. So as they adjudicate and make decisions in this critical time of challenge and crisis, there may be decisions that may lead to the health of our nation. Oh Lord, we pray for the many at the frontiers fighting this vicious battle. We pray for the doctors and the nurses and the first responders, those men and women who are sacrificially giving of their time and services and even giving the ultimate sacrifice of their lives because they love the service and they love the people. Oh Lord, the stench of death rises, and we hear the wail and the cries of pain and sickness and suffering. Oh God, you are a great mediator. You are a healer. And so come by here now and visit us. Walk among us and heal, restore. Give us hope. Give us the confidence that we can trust in our God. He's our refuge. You promised us that there will come a time when the immovable will move, but we are so confident that in Christ we have an answer. Bless us as a nation and as a people, and grant us an answer. Heal our land. In Jesus' name we ask it. Amen.
For us to pray and to understand that this is a time for us not to play. President George Washington said on the 17th day of October, 1789, he said that it is the duty of all nations that we must acknowledge the providence of God, to take note of his benefits that he has loaded with us daily, and to implore him in a time of need for favor and protection. This is indeed a time that governors have called for times of prayer and fasting and reflection. And we thank God today for our governor making this declaration and proclamation that today is a day that we ought to pray, fast, and reflect. I want to permit me just a few moments, if you can, if you go look in your words in your Bible, look at the scripture, Philippians chapter 4, verse 6. And there is where I want us to begin before we begin to pray. Philippians 4, chapter, verse 6. And it states, be anxious for nothing, but in everything, by prayer and supplication, with thanksgiving, let your requests be made known unto God. Let's pray. God, indeed, right now we call on you, the God of mercy and the God of grace, that you allow mercy to triumph over judgment. We come right now knowing that we dwell under your shadow. We abide where you dwell. We come right now acknowledging, God, that we need you in this territory. We need you in this world. We need you in these, your nations. We thank you right now, God, for who you are, that you are able. You are able to do exceedingly, abundantly, above all that we can ask or even imagine. So God, right now we use the words that you've given us, spirit and life, to prophesy over dead bones. We speak even now to things that seems to be bland and without your spirit. And God, we